it gets to that point, obviously, because Leshrac, if Complexity is able to win a fight, Leshrac's always like that kind of big one that he's able to take towers very easily. And now it's a Marana pickup for Cole, so that's probably cancels here on the mid lane.
We'll settle down a little bit for now. Z-Freak trying to cut Zai off. Actually, doesn't have the mana, but does have stick charges, so can charge out of here if need be. They've only got one way to interrupt it, not quite enough mana for the arrow, but they're going to have to combo soon. Crotch into an arrow available.
Dodge it.
What's the arrow? Oh, and Zai says, just kidding. But
that charges in,
and this might be a first blood. With Crit Therapy's on the high ground, the crush comes in again, not going to matter. Cancel, leaping forward towards the arrow. Once the crit kill, he will get it. He could get Zai as well. It might be a double. How many bashes will Zai get? He's going to need like two or three at least. He gets one, then the charge. One more should do the trick. It's going to be close. He doesn't get it. Cancel will survive, and gets away. He's even there to help Monkeys out, though. Arteezy sidestepping the arrow as well. Chase Monkeys a bit further. Yeah, definitely something that Slark can take advantage of. Let's go for the Iron Talon. We're gonna make the move around Zai. He charges onto Swindles, but that's also directly into the Diabolic Edict. Pay for that. It's caught between a rock and a hard place there with the Marana. Great scene that he does have level 6 now.
Definitely a lot of emphasis, though, as you're mentioning, on that mid lane. Putting one mid lane ward and one even behind the tower bottom lane. Monkeys forever. This is gonna be his
has
demise.
Has no TP. Already shielded before the Oko wound, so that's not even counting for the charge. But they could move in and catch crit. A crush here will be his death. Most likely Swindle's coming in, follow-up stun available, gets the kill, now needs to run away. The Arteezy, no open wounds for some time, but has the face boot advantage. Swindle's running in, and
Fades.
Like Shadow saving him. They might even be able to move back in on Zai if he's not careful. A crush here sets something up, but Swindle's a bit too low, and we'll just be duking out for a while. You really want to apply the pressure here in the mid lane, though. This tower is about to be in deny range now, as Cancel continues chipping away. Arrow having a fish, Zai could get crushed now. Last hit, though, not happening as the glyph gets popped. Crit trying to deny this tower. In the meantime, they're farming ancients. Zai gets hit by the double Starstorm. Might end up going down. Indeed, he will. Cancel finds the kill. The tower denied by crit, but was it worth the crit? He might die, too. Where is Arteezy? He's still farming the top lane. Now the tether out. Crit being pursued, though. Angry Fish on the case and in a lot of trouble. Surged away by Universe, but getting body blocked at the same time. Sprint has worn off. Looks like he should make it out. Even though the arrow pierces through the heart of the Ball of Light. Great snipe there by Cancel. Only now does Arteezy arrive, and it's to the bottom lane where he'll make short work of Swift. Yeesh.
Oh, right. Cancel's in some trouble right now. He does have the Moonlight Shadow, but he's charged up right now. Do they have the Dust? They do this time.
Yeah, the third time will not be the charm. Okay, they got good mileage on the first two, and still a bit of a support tax even when they do hack it. They are going to scout out Sumail. Let's just move for now, but he's got the night vision advantage. Sumail has not seen him just yet. Move, really playing with that night vision. Excellent footwork there, and now he makes the jump onto Sumail. Chemical Rage activated. They're still looking to chase, though. The smoke wraparound comes through right past Arteezy. They're going to look to go on him. He rages off the amp damage immediately. Now Z-Freak into the trees, looking for the IO instead. Swindle's already down to start the fight. They might get the Arteezy grab. No, he's to Zai! Coming in high and heavy. Taxi Etch's service. Now the tether to keep him alive a bit longer. Sumail hiding the trees on the wall. Great individual play by EG. Will they make it out, though? Sumail trapped alone and dead. They still get the kill on the Alk. Now Crit trying to escape, but doesn't have the TP for 10 seconds. Once an amp hits him, he too will fall. Doesn't even need the crush. Z-Freak fighting the kill. I mean, EG played that pretty cutely. it's not. Yeah.
That was a very clever movement. Arteezy does get out, which is the one detriment to him, but get a couple kills, which is great. And now mid lane, Arteezy might get hit by the stun. Oh, just
Swindles just barely missing. Bit of bad luck there. The EG now charging in, Z-Freak ready to interrupt the charge. Good setup there. The follow-up comes through. The brothers start to lay into Zai. They want to kill this sweet boy off, and they will do so. At the same time, though, Moose Lark will fall. And that's the bigger loss for sure. A one for one.
Like, they can just ignore the Alk for a bit and just keep fragging and then get to the point where they can deal with him, but still definitely very difficult to go for him.
With, like, enough items, it does feel like they have that opportunity. Zai is going to charge in direct down to Swindles with the Infest Bomb, unloads Arteezy. The turn comes, though, quickly. Zai will be brought down. Arteezy, the back away, so support for a support, and unfortunately, Deerbreaker down again.
Yep.
We need some armor items versus the Slardar going late game.
Yeah. Definitely, like the kind of the standard, right? The Octarine into Shiva's Guard. It's usually what we just see picked up. Moo, going for a solo pickup on crit, but his butt, nobody's near him. He's actually completely alone. He's got the Aegis, he's got Shadow Dancing.
I think he realized there was other people here, and now Moo in a lot of trouble. He's going to commit the ultimate, tries to run away, Shadow Dancing out, pouncing as well. He does have the Aegis. They can reset around him, go for a round two fight. but only if his team gets in position first. The arrow crashes in. Can he connect the Marchese while he's raged, so it doesn't get much done. Z-Brink's gonna likely die here on three, make it four hero charge by Zai, who delivers in spades. Mu there to turn this one, though. He continues to engage, still holds the Aegis. The crush comes through onto three. Great job. Can they focus down Universe? They will do, and suddenly cancel arrives, make it a two for two. EG on the run, Zai scrambling out. Marchese, though, getting the job done for now, takes the Abaddon with him at least. And now into the trees, they engage. A two hero stun from Sumail, but instantly Dark Pact off. Mu gonna try to bring him down, but just very slow, ineffective poking. The Aegis, I believe, expired during this time. Now he's gonna pounce out. He tries to run, unable to pursue over the tree line, but they get the charge. Zai's coming in, hot and heavy. Shadow Blade's there. Oh, so close to dying. He wants to go back in. Mu's gonna come in for this. He gets the kill. Can he jump out? You betcha he can, but the concoction takes him down. Was it worth it?
The Alchemist's power. They really don't have anything to do. Oh, and he's gonna get a free kill on Swindle here. Oh no, goodbye Swindles. 1-2.
That was
cash money.
A little too easy.
Like a creep. Casual farm right there.
Does have the Sheevas, as you mentioned. So really only a mood shards that he could grab or maybe trade something out for like an AC, get rid of that armlet potentially.
Yeah. More than likely, get rid of that armlet and grab something. I'm not sure if the AC could be pretty easy just to break high ground, but I think Arteezy would be more than likely the one to get that after, like...
Oh, that was a quick two-shot. This Leshrac just not feeling like a hero anymore. ZG, chase in, confident to move forward. They want a pipe to deal with this. Universe trying to work on one. It's still gonna be a while before the full pipe is completed, so a decent window here from Mirana at the big impact is Sumail. Aggressively sieging this tower, goes for a quick, short-duration stun on Z-Freak. Z-Freak continuing to sprint. Back away, Monkey's there to help him. Meanwhile, Zai charging in, it's gonna isolate, cancel, tries to bring him down, the Moonlight Shadow already committed, but he leaps out into a beautiful vacuum. Universe able to interrupt that one, can they focus him down? Defensive Ghost Scepter trying to escape, heading to the right instead, he's gonna live for now. Cancel not dead yet, but the Illusion Bird might take him down. Zai there with the charge, we'll finish him off. Three have fallen, about to be a fourth. Monkey's forever, already committed his ult. And out, by the way, still at full health. Arteezy's still quite healthy. They do get the IO, but it's enough. Just not keeping up in items. Alk net worth more than Mirana and Slark combined, to say nothing of their other cores still doing quite well in their own right. If they mow down the melee racks, the range bottom. I mean, game looking quite close to over, Yanni. So heading into game two, what kind of adjustments do you want to make of your complexity? Is this just the way they laned it? Is it more down to the picks? Where do you pin this one?
I mean, this is like Alchemist versus the world, kind of, in a way. There's actually no... They just can't deal with him at all. I mean, they banned the Storm last ban, which is definitely a good ban because they didn't have any lockdown, really, for him. So you can't really, like, blame them for doing that, but... What's worse, right?
Dealing with the Alchemist, what's worse is, this Arteezy just destroying you with lifesteal. All the while. I think they're gonna find Swindles here momentarily. Tries for a few seconds to pulse Nova. It's a fleeting effort by him, and he will go down. Meanwhile, Monkey's about to finish up.
Yeah,
so this is pretty much the end.
Like, Slark, like, when you third pick a Slark, especially, like, you're putting yourself in a position where they can kind of just, these heroes that ramp up in a faster manner. That's exactly what Alchemist does. Like, he farms at a five-fold rate over a Slark, and the Slark is able to just get non-stop pickup, but that's not gonna happen. Sumail's just, yeah, he just run it. He just doesn't care at all.
Yeah, he already gave someone an axe. I didn't actually get
to... Gave it to Universe. Yeah.
Yeah, you can't really blame Complexity for not game planning for the Alk, though, because it's looked so bad for EG the last, like, month.
I don't know if that's really, like, a good like, reason, though, to not, like... I mean,
I love
the last pick Alchemist, though.
I love the fact that they're still running it, but, like, at least, if it's not only about that, it's definitely more so about that.
I mean, if you want to be a tier 1 team in any manner, you have to be able to, like, play Alchemist at the manner. I mean, a hero is pretty ridiculous, especially as the last pick. Like, you can see how the damage potential that he just does. Like, he's unkillable. He died once when he wasn't online at all. But now it's when he's completely online and Clutch is just fighting not even just an uphill battle. It's like going up a mountain.
They're trying to scale the wrong side of the mountain first. This is just not looking great for them. Sumail killing off Swindles on one side of the map, basically. That's right, just a big bucket of gold for them. Is Cancel desperately trying to bring down crit. Arrow, though, could be tanked by Zai. That is a sign of friendship here.
By Cancel.
Cancel likely to be next. Focused down by Sumail. Mauled by the Spearbreaker and a little karate chop by the Conehead. We'll kill them all. They, meanwhile, we'll get the Arteezy kill. So the tears will flow from him, but PG overall, pretty solid. It's still a full HP Optimus, basically unkillable. We're gonna lob in the concoction, vacuum to combo with that. Nice two hero catch and make it 4, make it 5 complexity at some point. This is just bad for morale.
Or maybe even
Sunday, you could see them run.
I think they definitely ran. I cancel can play. He plays in pubs. His big three, I think, are like Alchemist, OD, and Murana. I think those are the ones. But yeah, you just look at the core pair up from EG in comparison to Cities, and you can kind of like feel like that kind of dictated the way the game was gonna go, unless somehow Complexity super snowballed in a way. But it's
they
just
run,
way too
they run Meepo, by the way, Complexity. I don't think they.
No, they don't have a Meepo player. So they said they have, like, you know, scaling potential into, like, the later stages with Lifestyle and Invoker. They have even more wombo combo for team fight with the Earth Spirit and Darkseer and Invoker.
There was no Banish with the DD, and I think they had a window there. But, I mean, it's not quite right.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Arteezy bottom lane trying to fight, but Z-Freak, very scary as the zombie man, gets off another decay, though he is dropping pretty low, jukes into the trees, has
fairy
charges,
stick.
Has Sal, has Fairy Fire, and has Tango. Monkey's just gonna sprint, phase right past him, gets the two hero crush, here comes the turnaround, perhaps Monkey's low though, Z-Freak trying to get onto Zai as quickly as possible, that tether slow is doing work, but Crit meanwhile does find the first blood, he went back in on mid, gets the kill, then Monkey's may drop to Arteezy, may well know the heal from Z-Freak, the Sun Dying Pick really paying off, the Sunstrike coming in with the open wound slow, kaboom, Arteezy will find him. Make it 2. So Sumail off to a hot start now.
How's top lane going? How's this
Universe
last track
is
doing?
Just having a...
I kind of expected. Like it's a dark
move. Pounce away, boulder smash, a double whiff by Crit, just barely though. As he tries to keep eyes on Moon, not level 6 yet, this is the time to punish him. Through the trees he goes, winding his way. Still has the Quelling Blade. Crit getting juked slightly, quelling his way out, but still the Ion Shell burning, and Crit's persistence pays off. Finds the kill anyway, man. I thought Moo was getting it out there. That combo not going to be very effective. Lifestealer with the instant rage.
Yes. Sumail pulling quite far ahead in this mid lane, though. Cancel only sitting at 14 CS. Moo getting heavily pressured. Top lane, he does have the pounce to get away, but he silenced vacuum, and he's dead again.
Such a good job at just punishing the Slark right before he hits 6. Once he's 6, kill's almost certainly not happening, at least not just with these two. Now the TP out, Crit going to roll away. Doesn't have a teleport scroll, but they're not even gonna bother chasing him. Time, but Slark has pretty good vision. Anyway,
he probably saw like the minimap icon and just got afraid there instead of like actually seeing clicking on him and seeing how long he actually was bottom lane.
Bottom lane, Monkey's gonna go down. So Complexity, nothing really working out. Swindles will get the edict off. Arteezy does not have a rage, but he has an infest available. There's the pounce in for Moo, and quickly looking to escape. Should be able to pop out momentarily, just waiting for the rage to cool down. I believe.
Yep, and he's good. Canceled on him. Now at the rotation.
Pippin here, Zai's not level 6 yet, though he is close. And they're gonna look to find him as he tries to tether his way out of this one. Zai will get caught, focused on Arteezy into the river. Monkeys does have the sprint available. He's currently open wounds, but it's about to wear off.
Catch him.
If he can get a crush, it should lead to a kill. Very little mana on Arteezy, trying for the juke, but you can't juke. Fish. Swindles will move in, but if there's a melee creep here, tanking up the Diabolic Edict, he's even gonna grab a bounty rune, he might even get Roche tonight. They can't be letting this happen. Crush, banish, no chance. But meanwhile, all that chasing, it's a tier 1 for EG.
Very early mech on top of that, and Crit, being up there with Universe constantly, he's already level 5 on this roaming Earth Spirit. So it's very good for him getting that early level 6. And Sumail even picks up an 8-minute Midas bottom lane. Zai getting pressure pretty heavily,
but is
Zai
gonna find a double kill here? He's turning around for Crit. He's gonna get one. He looks towards Monkeys.
Oh, he's relocating.
Come in! Got him! Another connection! He relocates forward, but the XP will go to Sumail.
Look, he's in the bottom lane now. He doesn't really know where to go. Top lane is obviously a great place for him to farm, but...
Oh boy. Complexity going for the ambush, but little do they know, EG with the next level ambush of the ambush. Coming in hot, they're gonna go for the stun on the walk, and then Sunstrike finding the connection as Zai tethers out. In comes Crit with the roll forward. There's a banish, and EG looking to reset the fight. Moo charging forward. The tombstone is here. Nobody focusing in. Has to infest and pop away. Arteezy coming back into the vacuum. He's surviving through a courtesy of the tether. How does this lifestealer live? The dog survives forever and a day, and now the chase back in to Z-Freak. They'll kill off the Undying 2. 3 dead Moo. Hiding in the trees. No teleport for 19. I don't think EG realized it. Hey, Sunstrikes, but he's just pushing in the mid lane. They might get 2 towers now.
Yeah, 4v5 in there. Universe getting the pretty much a god tier. Three-man vacuum into wall, setting up everything for them. And now he's got the mech coming out there. That was without mech on Unity. But well, he actually might
be. It would also be a huge kill. They're gonna commit a Dark Pact here.
Oh my god.
He goes down, but it comes at the cost of two more heroes. Now Swindle's running, and the feed train has arrived, and EG collect their bounty. The death pulses from the Diabolic Edict will at least kill off Zai, but still, map control a big priority now for EG.
Yeah, usually with like, especially like with complex lineup, like you have a Leshrac, you have an Undying, you really need your early game to go super well. They're already like, yeah, it's on such a back, but now top lane crit actually does miss the boulder smash, so there's no stun there. Gets Astral'd up, but Zai's in position there, they should probably be able to find the kill here on crit. Let's see if the reload kick gets him out. It does, the crit off, the stun off the mark.
And you are bottom, look at Sumail for the combo, the back can come through. They've already brought down one to start this fight, and he looks for more. It's complexly gonna send the whole gang. But Arteezy has joined the fray as well. Sumail low, not dead just yet. Mu trying to focus him down. Can they get the kill? It's a huge one. And they do secure it. Can Mu make it out? Now it's a question. A good crush by monkeys. Staggered retreat as Arteezy slowly moves forward and then changes his mind, says, get me out of here. While that was all happening, they also get the Zai kill. EG giving up big ones. Now that did cost them a slaughter buyback.
Mentioned he's level 11 too, so he's having a pretty decent farming game. He's up on the net worth somehow. I actually don't know how he has 54 CS on an Undying. That's pretty surprising.
He's smoking straight towards the Roche pit. Swindle's there to tank it. Ideal hero to do tank that gank, but that might not be it. Z-Freak dropping the tomb. It's on the high ground. Good position. EG don't really have many heroes to focus it down. Can they find Universe? A crush could set up a kill. There's the pounce as well, but a beautiful boulder smash. Crit runs out of mana. He got off the magnetize into the vacuum, but it's not enough damage. Complexity all heal right back up the mech from Z-Freak, making the difference there. So they blow the wall. They had the magnetize, and now Complexity straight into the Roche pit.
Probably just split push. I don't think they're going to make it in time to contest this, but Crit is, looks like he's in position to try to do something. The tombstone is gone. Everybody's starting to get beat down a bit. They do have the illusion to be able to scout out inside the pit, but Mu does have that Shadow Blade up. He's able to get the wraparound on Crit. He's able to get the setup. Arteezy getting the burst on Z-Freak. Sunstrike off the mark, but yeah, easily kill there. Mu misses the pounce.
This would be a big kill though. Arteezy has no escape mechanisms prepared except for an IO relocate perhaps. The IO, keep him alive for now with the tether, will be fine for the moment, but they're very low. Move fences around, running to go back in. There's an amp on Arteezy, but now he heals back up. He's got the mana to work with as well. Boulder Smash connecting on Move. He's currently able to hide in the Shadow Dance, now the Shadow Blade. Moving forward, looking for the pick, could move on to crit, maybe just kill off that Earth Spirit, but the balls are hitting him, they know he's in the neighborhood, and meanwhile, the vacuum comes in, three heroes into the ice wall, beautiful combo with the Dipping Blast as well, but the counterplay perhaps for Mu, bringing them all low, can he finish anyone off? Arteezy's working on Zai, also about to drop the Banish, should finish the job, but still, they've lost their Slark, they've lost three, and Zai actually not going to die to the Banish, he heals through it all, survives and cancel with the Hurricane Pike away, but Sumail on the chase has a Sunstrike at the ready, they relocate forward, this could just set up for that very Sunstrike. He's gonna drop it a little bit too late. Sumail not connected. It's not over yet. Zai trying to get out as the relocate expires. Won't happen, but again, no vacuums from Universe. Isn't gonna be sufficient. Another banish by cancel. Kiting him out. EG, they've bit off more than they can chew. They'll drop four. Ay, caramba. It could have been five the other way, Giannis. Throw vacuums in that fight if they still didn't win. Yeesh. Impressive how long the IO is surviving as well, I do have to say.
Yeah. Unfortunately there, the big problem for Complexity is, oh wait, they might actually be able to get a setup here on crit.
Good stun by Swindles to follow this one up, and Arteezy committing on the Swindles, but
Arteezy
the Banish
gonna die. Yeah,
with the saves, two more kills, EG heavily punished and straight in erosion. This time, it looks like a freebie.
And everybody else died afterwards, so his team benefited a lot from him, but he definitely needs to in this type of lineup, because it can't just be canceled.
They're gonna show Mu mid. The rest of the team smoking ahead of him, and they walk straight into Arteezy, but he's already raged, he's prepared for this. Good defensive Astral with the Sunstrike set up on the Swindles, now vacuuming back in Z-Freak, commits the Greaves, Hammer gets dropped, magnetizes well, cancel rushing into the fray, directly on top of Zai, modeling down the ball of light, we'll get that first kill, now turning back to Arteezy, the boulder smash, they can't deal with his OD, he's still got the Aegis available, but Monkeys drops low, magnetize will finish him up, continues to tick, 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 who's gonna drop? It's a triple for crit, he takes the whole team down on his own, the hero spirit alone. Delivers. And Sunstrike. Not gonna find a kill. Crit, he thinks about heading in the jungle. Well, that could have been fake for Complexity, but they actually go the other way.
Aegis reclaimed, that's why they go for the smoke button. They know
smoke
it's gonna be getting taken
broken.
Out right now.
Crit with the instant jump up onto the high ground, straight onto the OD of all heroes who just lost that Aegis, as he mentioned, Z-Freak though. He will pop down the tomb. Already the pipe committed. Z-Freak's gotta push away. With the tombstone down this early, it could be bad. Crush comes through, but Tomb fully destroyed. OD has BKB now, though. This could be the game changer. Forward cancel. He jumps back into the fray, but it's before the BKB actually arrives. They're bringing this Undying low. They finish him off with the Deafening Blast cancel. Yeah, he's got BKB. Does he really want to fight? Sumail just get a Ghost Walk away. That's a 10-second charge down the drain. They also lost Z-Freak around the tower while that was happening. What we'll deal with is that split push, that map control, and constantly having the creep equilibrium advantage.
It's definitely a bit scary to fight into Complexity's on just Young cancel. They have to get him blown up instantly inside of one stun, but Monkeys now shows his face in the front line. EG's all in the area.
Move constantly fencing around to the sides, trying to find that squishy Io. The BKB committed by cancel.
He's in the back line.
But he does get on the Zai. Can he focus the Zai down? Pretty squishy, and will end up dropping. That's a great pick by Mu to start the fight. Instant buyback, though. Look for the re-engage. The Meteor trying to roast him. Deafening Blast a bit late. They will find the kill on Monkeys, but he will skirt away, salvaging the gem, at least for now. Z-Freak, though, in trouble. Boulder Smash comes through, trying to bring him down, keep him out of the fight. Cancel force him to roll away. Swindles charges back in, but Z-Freak also about to fall. That's two supports down. The hammer gets dropped, making some big kills the other way. Swindles still alive through it all. The Banish by Cancel saves him. They'll get all five with the dieback on the IO, and they keep the gem. There's some gold for Mu.
There's
a courier there. Oh, he didn't actually see it.
Yeah, it's actually hidden in the fog, too. Cancel in a decent position, but the ward is seeing him crit might well for this instant lockdown on
him. This is gonna be a tough kill. They're gonna try for it, so they get the bash here by Ortiz. They're gonna need it. Boulder Smash, pull him back. He pops the BKB, but this time he's a one shot. Sunstrike I heard going off. Z-Freak gonna find the get blown up by Sumail. He has to buy back immediately. Beautiful Deafening Blast. Good combo damage here.
Ortiz is dead though. He actually gets isolated and brought down by the Slaughterkin Lushstrike and Slaughter combo.
He's gonna duke it out with crit. Now the Boulder Smash pullback, good magnetized by him. Cancel pretty low, no BKB, can't confidently roll in this time. Force out the buyback there.
Uh-oh, this could be huge for Complexity here. They pick up a DD on the Slark. Their Aegis just got reclaimed from Cancel, but EG
and
looks
EG
like they
want to
fight.
Do something here. They want to make that move on the Cancel. They've got a completely changed on him. He BKBs, he looks to turn. They do get the bash off from Ortiz. He actually has the completed Abyssal Blade. Still Cancel able to kite control through this fight on the backline's crit. Getting off the magnetize, the boulder smash through. The wall gets dropped, and on top of it all, Monkeys forever stands strong for now. The Undying Heal, Tornado, connected to Ortiz. They try to focus him down. They will blow him up. The meatball rolls in. Sumail's still at full HP, working in tandem with Crit to bring these other heroes down. Mu surviving, bouncing back into the fray, and now Sumail wants to run. There's a double buyback by Complexity, desperate to win this fight. They've committed a lot, but it looks like it should be the full five-man wipe for them. A triple for Mu, who never died. They hang onto the gem. He suddenly got 3k gold. I imagine overall net worth-wise, it's pretty close since they double bought back, but he positioned properly, can only be hitting mostly hitting that melee Rex anyway. There are some buffer buildings with the Edict, and then head right on towards bottom. EG about to get double Rex by Complexity, up by 10,000 gold. They led early this game. They led actually peaking around a 12k gold lead at sub 30 minutes, but it has become all Complexity all the way now. Crawled back into this game on the back of a really good OD performance by Cancel. Supporting cast playing well around him. Good stacks, jumping away. Trying to play very fearlessly. Oh, look at this. Solar Crest now. Interesting build by him. They're gonna try to find Monkeys Forever early in this fight, but again, the saves come out from Z-Freak, drops the tomb. EG, thinking of running, Sumail's gonna try to focus it down, lobs out the tornado, will connect on the Slardar, but even the meatball, he's gonna back away. Lincoln's already pumped, they've committed the pipe, it's still the chase forward. Monkeys wants to go. Mu, jumping in, there's the leap, connects on crit, looking for more, they're gonna have a crush soon. Monkeys chasing, the urn comes through, but it's a bit too late, he does get the crush. Will the follow be there? Zai with the tether out. EG, oh, trying to retreat, but Moose got your back door covered. They'll sweep in with the drive-by. Suddenly 13. Essence Shift stacks and Complexity.
Those little plays. You see Mu with that Sentry Ward on the high ground.
It's starting to feel a little tentative. Complexity. Gonna BOT cancel in. Courier swinging forward. Mu threatening to jump, but not just yet. Universe wall, they're busy waiting. He vacuums, Deafening Blast, wall, magnetized, the whole enchilada onto Complexity, dropping them all low. Cheese comes down though, Monkey surviving. Mu, BKB now charging forward, looking for those Essence Shift stacks on design. We'll bring him down. Swindles runs in, raining down the pain with the OD hammer and more damage to follow. Sumail, bash, focus, almost dead. Invoker, oh, I'll lean forward. BKB still going, won't matter, that's four. And there's no buyback. GG. I mean, that was like the dream combo from EG on his
That was perfect.
They just didn't have the follow up.
Yeah.
Brewmaster. Interesting.
So, not an easy hero to burst down. They don't have any silences.
Weaver.
The reply from Complexity rounded out, of course, the Weaver.
He's like clean rotations, just mess with him a bit.
They're leeching a lot of experience. It's going to be three heroes emerging into this lane rather quickly, but Zai getting forced back, bullied by the auto text as Ifrigu went for the early boots. He does leap out, really good timing there. Now going to follow up with the arrow, nails Arteezy, but Ogre arrives, and all of a sudden it's Monkeys who wants to run. He's pretty tanky, but the blocks are there from Crit. Monkeys in danger, into the trees he goes. He'll have a charge fairly soon, but the move speed a little bit more. No, it's the Living Armor to save the day. He charges out past the wave to the Rage Creep, up and out of there.
They've got a stun.
They still have the stun. And with that, one more auto attack. The arrow just a bit too late. Almost made it out. A big commitment, but they do get the first blood on the Spirit Breaker.
That versus EG, they have Panda Split already. Super hard for them really to be able to pressure towers as well, with like, with only like a Weaver able to really be in the front line to be able to hit anything. The Spirit Breaker is a frontline hero, but you know, if he's showing on the map, there's no gank potential.
Sumail getting very aggressive here, just spinning right in. He has the healing ward, the tether from Zai, confident that he can take this fight, but Monkeys is going to TP and look for the charge. The Nether Strike as well, all of this commitment onto Sumail, but he survives through it all. Arteezy's going to come in, look to turn this thing around, has the God Strength ready, goes to work. Monkeys forever. Again, they're able to use the Moonlight Shadow to get out of here. EG, just no detection for the time being. He charges forward once more onto Sumail with the Swarm even there, affecting him, but it won't matter. They lose their OD. The arrow comes in from Z-Freak. Leap, Starfall, barely doing any damage. It's not enough, the evasion. Finally, they get the kill on Universe, but at what cost as the turnaround comes from that big old sword and transitions immediately into the Ancients. But now, God Strength is worn off, so.
Just do with the Sentry on top, but EG, they see the opportunity to both just push the towers down with their massive five men with Bloodlust, Tether, and Healing Ward whenever they want to use it.
Uh-oh.
Oh, Z-Freak.
Z-Freak, a rare whiff there on the pounce. He is going to try to go invis. They spin onto him, removing the Living Armor. He will be banished, Dust committed through this, but I believe Morana might have a chance. No, never mind that. It's going to get the Starfall off. We'll go down. B now being pursued. The bugs come through. Will there be follow-up? Move committing on Desire. Really wants to bring him down. Good overgrowth, but where's the combo? They need the OD to come in and drop the hammer. He doesn't have much stolen in. Very ineffective fight. And now the Brew Split looking for another. They'll dispel that tornado. Stun follow from Arteezy. Likely another kill. Two will drop, and EG just plunging forward down the mid lane. On the tower to keep it alive. Monkeys now in the trees, but they saw it, and they ping him out. Arteezy with the hill ward. Had some vision of it coming. Sumail's going to surge his way forward. They look to engage here. Complexity getting hesitant, and while they hesitate, EG seizing the moment, but there's the overgrowth. Will there be follow-up? Swindle's focus brought down first. The charge comes through. It's a four-hero pile-up with the swarm, but do they have the damage? The Warcry making everyone arrow very tanky. Even an arrow under Arteezy. Can they focus him down? Zai is there trying to save him. The relocate a bit too late. They will lose their Sven. They're likely to lose crit as well. This is the kind of fight that Complexity wanted. This is the kind of fight they needed. The universe now being charged. Goes for the clap. Doesn't have mana for the split. The arrow's gonna connect. Z-Freak slams it home. Make it three. It could be four. As Zai rejoins the fight, Complexity, a huge win for them already, and make it the four-hero pile-up indeed. They'll find all the kills. It was so close to going differently. Almost got the relocate save. Almost got the brew split off, but none of it happened.
After the into the charge after the overgrowth, so very nice teamwork coming out for Complexity, but EG, they still have that Panda Split, they still have the spell and ultimate, they want to fight.
They move on to Z-Freak first and foremost, but he manages to leap away. The banish though almost helping as EG will get to reset around him. They begin to engage. Monkeys though with a good charge through. The Living Armor making the difference, keeps him alive. Arteezy, already the Brewmaster down, and he's not able to hit anyone, even though he's empowered with the God Strength. They can reset here after the banish. Z-Freak, arrow cooling down. Sumail will Blade Fury, but that could allow for a big one. Will he find the angle? They're going to banish, charge. Not the perfect teamwork, but if the arrow connects, likely a kill. There is no relocate save. Sumail being focused down. Mu will get the kill. Now they're bashing Arteezy back with the Nether Strike and the orbs coming in. Complexity is heating up on Design next. Mauling the Ball of Light. They'll kill him off too. First it was four, and this time it's going to be five. An ultra for Mu. Complexity steamrolling forward from the depths of despair, down 0-1 and 12k gold into game two. All of a sudden, they've got EG on the ropes.
He's got to be careful. Blade Fury won't save you against Spirit Breaker.
He's going in.
Coming in hot, Sumail. In a lot of trouble now. Doesn't even get off the spin. Getting focused down by the OD. Nether Strike. Easy kill. Complexity. Continue to roll. Down in the river with OD starting to move in. Window is about to close with Z-Freak getting this Aghanim Scepter. They're going to be in a lot of trouble. God, it would be great to kill him now. He is going to leap away. He has a TP, but they get onto him. 15 gold short. The Astral might buy him the time to get the Aghanim Scepter. It's going to be Clone Seafreak. 5 gold. He doesn't even bother to buy the component. The Living Armor. No, not enough. He will end up going down. The hammer gets dropped, though. And now Cancel looks for the fight, focusing on Zai. The Blade Fury's there as well. They commit the split. They brought down 2. Buyback on the Mirana. He only has 1 component and 900 gold to go down. And Mu, Jade Stud, focus down during God's Face. A chaotic fight from Complexity. Starstorm will kill off Zai, but that's it. After the buyback in Z-Freak, it could be a dieback with the clap coming in. They're going to commit a lot to kill up this Mirana where he basically had an eggs. We're now looking at him being set back a full 3 to 4 minutes with that death. Well, yeah, double death.
Yep.
And Z-Freak in position. He's got the eggs now. Could set this one up with an arrow. Roshan complete. EG still storming in. They've got the high ground advantage. Moonlight Shadow committed. Blink into the pit. Arteezy off the mark with that one. Do they look for the turnaround now? Blade Fury early. By Sumail, he's getting hesitant, charge gets canceled, everybody getting cold feet in this fight as the stun goes out onto cancel, but remember, he's the Aegis Bear. Arrow committed, it hits crit. Is that the best target? Not really sure about that. Monkeys forever is being focused down. Sumail will kill him off with Bloodlust Autotext. Now the Overgrowth Swindle's trying to negate the Brewmaster split as much as possible. Z-Freak could be the secret damage dealer. Cancel will have a second life to work with, but they're hounding this Mirana out of the pitch. He leaps up and away. This isolates in turn Cancel as they continue pursuit. Sumail's starting to work on him. They commit a Dust. Now that's just the Aegis. Now they got to kill him off again, but they're down 2. Make it 3 as he comes back. They'll try to re-engage. All the cores are alive, though, and Mu on the chase. Z-Freak leap cooling down. They can chase this. Hammer gets dropped. Look for a bit more. Warcry and a scramble back as Arteezy gets scouted out by the pesky little bug. They isolate him. They're going to follow this up with an arrow. They'll kill him off too. Arteezy dead as well. That's 3. They did pop the Aegis. They get 2 supports. They hemorrhage quite a few kills in their own right.
So he's going to be able to dish out a lot of damage in the back lines, take out the supports for sure if he's able to find that positioning with this blink.
Oh, Arteezy. He does have the BKB, but the cancel with the sneaky move by Cancel. And Viz coming in from behind. Has to be careful about Sentries because they do have the Mirana, so EG might have planted some down. There is one, but it's kind of close to the tower.
Oh, they see Cancel
now. Getting revealed, he's going to self-banish. The team has to scramble to back him up. They will have an Overgrowth. They can try. The Hurricane pikes himself backwards towards safety, but doesn't quite get over the tree line where an Omni Slash isolates him together with the Multicast. He's down very early in the fight. BKB of Arteezy, the Overgrowth there. Arrow pierces the heart of Zai, will bring him down. And now EG starting to work with Arteezy there, but he's getting kited a bit. The moon, the Star Storm's coming in hotter and heavier as Arteezy has to turn tail and run. Crit also, dear life, trying to limp away. Tree even hitting that ogre. Not very effective at this stage with the armor he has, but they do successfully hang on
and force
the buyback. This does ramp up his farm speed even further, and they look to move in. From the low ground, though, don't have the vision uphill. More than once, we've seen them drop a ward right next to the shop and then just leap in. That was a big play. They made a lot in game 2. Not going to happen just yet. But Mu in position. Now they're going to start this off. They do manage to break his Lickit Spear. Chain stun and focus him down. Is he going to buy back and re-time-lapse into the fight? He will do so. Time-lapsing in from the rear. Immediately coming to work with the bugs. Brains down Zai. The charge on the crit. Focusing him down too. Brew never got off the split. Without his control, they might not have a chance in this fight though. Sumail and Arteezy combining nicely. Diffusal Blade there. Now Sumail needs to run away. He gets purged. He's being focused. He purges off the purge. The counter purge indeed. Only Kevin were casting this game. Now Arteezy, focus down. He will fall. That's 4. Great buyback there by Mu. Fight on if he has buyback and is willing to commit it, because he can just instantly rejoin the fight. The buyback time-lapse play.
Yep.
So they got the benefit of the swarm. They committed a lot just to break the Lincoln Sphere and then kill him as Cancel will move in. This is going to prompt a Bruce, but they better get something done with this crit. Fanging the bugs now. The charge through by monkeys. Great way to deal with those panda aspects. So far, being largely negated in this fight. Cancel now moving forward. Moves in pretty deep. Now got a time-lapse back out. Arteezy's blown the God Strength. Has the BKB. The God Strength still quite a bit of time left on it. Omni Slash coming through. Not getting a heck of a lot as they overgrow through this. Leaping forward with Z-Freak, but the BKB now committed. Good patience by Arteezy. Wants to bring down Cancel, but again, the kiting of the Astral friggin' imprisonment. He survives this. They get 3 more kills, and they're going high ground. There's no BKB on Sven. There's no Brewmaster split. There's no God Strength. And then they're minus 3 heroes.
No one actually has buyback. They might just have to force one of their heroes to just go in and die and then just buy back afterwards to make sure they don't lose 2 Raxes, because this 2 Raxes is pretty hard to come back from.
Well, everyone counted out Complexity, I think, or at least the vast majority. Certainly you and I didn't have a whole lot of faith in them. Even after game 2, you just look at EG's results and have to say they're favored. But Complexity, battling back, great adjustments in the draft. The OD has been massive for them in both of these games. This game, they haven't won yet, but it is looking real bleak for EG.
Yeah, Cancel and Mu both like having great position in these fights, but Z-Freak's arrows have been on point this game, landing.
Just bashing 3-4 of them on the way through, and then of course the Sven.
being controlled largely by
Monkeys, that. Monkeys here in a spot where he might just go down here. They have the Moonlight Shadow. Do they have detection for him? They do. They have a Dust on Zai.
One last swing of that hammer will get the kill. Just a bit too quick to die, or they could have turned, but Cancel's going to set up. They have buyback on Spearbreaker. Arrow coming through. Long duration stun on the probably the least important hero at this stage, too. Mao just sees this, and he comes rushing in. Swindle's there. Panning back for now. They're going to commit a lot onto this OD. Buyback now for the Spearbreaker as Moo's being focused, but he's just going to time-lapse it off. Lives for now, and they get the Lotus Orb reflected stun, but Arteezy PKB's to dodge it. Then the Overgrowth comes through, gets to work with that big hammer. Moo doesn't have time-lapse, has to be careful. Being focused, chain stun brought down by the crits. That's a dieback on the Spearbreaker. Now they can look for a third kill. They've also killed off the Weaver, who doesn't have buyback. They've gotten one late, but they've got to be careful not to give up one in turn. Z-Freak with the Lotus Orb used defensively, and now focusing on the OD. They bring him down. Or actually, no, he survives for the time being. That's the Aegis. Now they bring him down. But can they kill him a second time? That's the question. Shiva's guard committed. Swindle's coming back into the fray. Drops the hammer. Unloads it. Not enough just yet, but the Living Armor, the Lotus Orb, the pushback. He's still surviving.
Still
Cancel.
Alive.
It's
oh, my
triple.
God.
It's an ultra kill. OD devours all. GG.
And they just called it GG. That was sick plays by Universe in that fight, too. He threw Cancel up, like, I think two or three times with the Panda Spirits, but there's too much on complexity. This buyback from Monkeys, even though he just flew in and died, this OD combo with the tree.